You will see television set, TV, you know, all kind of news channels. The reason for this is these remote operation centers operate on a 24/7 basis. They need to know what is happening, they need to know what time zone they have been talking to, what kind of data centers they will be monitoring, and what will be the time there, so that they know whether that escalation mechanism, how exactly that needs to be handled. So the remote monitoring center should be equipped with the state-of-the-art monitoring equipment, the enterprise management tools, and the connectivity for various locations. And it can be either a shared remote operation center or a dedicated remote operation center, depending on what kind of requirement the client has. So that this is the first requirement when you need to have remote infrastructure management. Then we have the connectivity. So each client has to be connected through firewalls, or you know, basically having a point-to-point contact connectivity, so that you will be able to sit in a remote location and actually have the connectivity to their network, so that you can monitor and manage their environment. And at the same time, you also need to have connectivity to your company's network very well firewalled, so that you can access certain things which are required from your company perspective, like the emails, like the intranets, like the portals, those kind of areas. So it has to be a very secure environment, secure connectivity, what you need to have, so that you demonstrate that the IP of your client is protected completely. And then you have to have the voice connectivity. So the voice connectivity needs to have a call center infrastructure, because you need to take the calls across the globe. You need to have the ability to provide a toll-free number. You need to have the ability to contact all the countries where your client has got business, because the IT infrastructure will be typically spread across the locations. You need to have the ability to monitor those calls. You need to have the ability to determine the response time, the resolution time, the hold time, and all those metrics which are required for you to maintain a service. The important factor in the infrastructure management is that you need to work with your clients in such a way that you maintain certain agreed service level agreements. Without SLA, the SLA are maintaining 99.999% availability. So these are certain parameters, or having 20 seconds response time, having 3 hours resolution time. So these are certain metrics which you agree with your client, and agree with your client, fashion are no longer, you know, some kind of a luxury. They all have become hygienic factors today. So you need to provide those kind of SLAs. So for doing that, you need to have the infrastructure at your place, so that you will be able to monitor and actually produce these metrics and reports to demonstrate that you have met and exceeded the SLAs. This is something which most of the clients of remote infrastructure worry about, insist upon, and make sure that these are adhered to, the security controls. You need to have different kinds of security controls depending on which customers you are working with. Let us look at the financial segment. They need certain very stringent security controls. They need security controls. They need biometric access controls. They need media movement restrictions. So you cannot take any media outside, or you cannot bring any media inside. They need complete audits and trails of the data exchange which has happened. So that is very important from this particular point perspective. The importance of the storage is the ever growing storage requirement is also one of the factor for this. Is you need to provide audit and trails. You need to provide audit and trail. You need to have the data addressed, so that you know you can provide and pick up the information as and when you want it. So those kind of information need to be given. You need to have network security. You need to have firewalls. You need to have encryption. You need to have the data movement restrictions. You need to have physical security. You need to have logical security. So when you are security, so when remote infrastructure management, you need to be very clear that your clients expect this. So it may be very depending on the needs of the client, but you need to have the ability to provide all different kinds of security, all different kinds of. So then you need processes. You know, they say something, and typically in the space, in the infrastructure space, whoever is there, 48 hours of border and 5 minutes of extreme action. Because you need to be monitoring, and most of the time, 98% of the time nothing happens, but when any incident happens, you need to act really fast, really quick. Because any downtime means there's dollar value or a rupee value for any downtime. So that is very important for us to make sure that we monitor and manage with strong processes. So more than anywhere else, the infrastructure management processes become extremely important. Today, the industry recognized standard is ITIL standards for IT information library and ITSM, IT service management. These are the two frameworks which are extensively used in the infrastructure management. And you need to abide by this framework. And it is very important that, you know, you stick to certain processes. Typically what happens in the infrastructure management space is, that's a Bible in which if certain things happen, what are you supposed to do? What exactly are the steps? How exactly are you going to escalate? What is your time frame for resolving the problem? And what are the things you are not supposed to do? So all these things will be documented and kept documented. And typically these are found, these run books originated from the space agencies, where they used to have T-24, T-2, T-.